Hey guys, Jason the Lazy Heretic here, and we are back up to date. Yes, day 8. I'm just checking my watch because I'm checking the date. It's day 8 because it's the 8th of December today, and we are continuing talking about hope. We're going to talk about hope today and tomorrow. So we've got one more day after today, one more day after today of talking about hope, and then we'll be done for our first week of Advent devotionals. So I'm really excited about that, and I'm really excited to talk about hope. And last night when I uploaded this video, it was nighttime for me. Now it's daytime, which is great. Last night I talked about what is our hope and the resurrection life, and what that means, and the fact that we get to live a resurrected bodily existence, that the Bible never says that our existence is going to be spiritual in our new creation and our new home in Jesus comes again, when we are raised from the dead. It's not to some kind of spiritual existence. It's not to some sort of like ether kind of existence where we just float around on clouds. It is a definite spiritual existence. And so we get to see in the scriptures that idea that we will be raised and our lowly bodies will be transformed, is the words that we looked at yesterday. And then I wanted to pick up a little bit more on what the world will look like in that kind of setting, when we, because of course we got a body, we need somewhere to live, we need somewhere to exist, and some space to inhabit, because bodies are spatial things. So we've got to take up some space, we've got to have some space to live in. And so there has to be this new creation, there has to be a renewing of the earth, a kind of a recreation of what that, of the initial thing. If God's going to restore, if our hope is the restoration of all things into the way that they were supposed to be, God's going to restore that, and the earth is going to be restored, and we're going to have that kind of existence. So we get this picture in Revelation 21, if we go right to the end of the Bible, and the picture that John gives us is of the New Jerusalem coming down out of heaven as a bride adorned for a husband, and a voice from the throne, so God the Father, saying, "Behold, the dwelling place of God is with man, and that there's no more tears, no more pain, no more death, no more mourning, because all the former things have passed away." And that's one of my favorite verses in the Bible, because that speaks to us of what the end game is. We talked about this a few times, is that the end game for us is what's important. That's where our hope is. Our hope is in what God's promises are. And we talked about how we can trust God because he has been faithful in the past. We've never known him to break his promises. We've never known him to kind of say, "Yeah, I'll do this," but then not do it. He's always done the things that he said he'd do. The biggest instance of that, of course, being sending Jesus to initiate this restoration, initiate this kind of recreation, this renewal of the earth. And so that's the thing that we look forward to. And so that's where our hope is. Our hope is in this new creation, this new city, where the dwelling place of God is with man, where he dwells amongst us, where he dwells in our midst, and we can even more, because I know we have the Holy Spirit who dwells inside us and kind of convicts us and is a foretaste of that, but our actual hope is the physical experience of that, no longer kind of in the separated out from the world, but the world and the church and God's kingdom all becoming one in this new creation. So that's something that I think is worth looking forward to. That's something that we can hope for. That gives us a reason to live, gives us a reason to strive towards God, because that's the picture that we want to be a part of. And that's what Advent points us to. Advent, of course, is about the first arrival of Jesus, but it also points us to the second arrival of Jesus, the arrival of him at the end of time, when heaven comes to earth, when there's new creation initiated, and we get to live that new life. So we're going to finish up tomorrow talking about the last kind of aspect of hope and what that looks like and how it affects how we live today, because this hope is not just for the future, but it has an effect on us today. So I hope you're enjoying these devotionals. Let me know in the comments if you want. Subscribe, send me a message, whatever you want. I'd love to interact, love to hear from you. But other than that, we'll see you tomorrow, okay? God bless, guys.